finally got to the gym. Sluggish, but I did it. What's up, guys? Welcome to, what day is it? Jeez, I always do this. Tuesday's vlog. What is going on, guys? It is the next day. This is me struggling getting in the gym. Finally got there. I'm saying finally, but I only took Monday off and I still went Sunday. It just feels like a while. So here's what I really wanted to discuss. My thoughts were scattered and I was trying to vlog this yesterday. You're looking at this chart right now. So these are the main three things that we as people following Dr. Bernstein program need to follow to have a successful, follow this program successfully, essentially. Number one is the law of small numbers. For those of you who read the book, you already know that. When you input small numbers, you output small mistakes. So, you know, as you're starting the program, you're obviously going to make a lot of mistakes, even throughout, you know, wherever you are. Same here. I'm still making my mistakes, and I've been in the program for a year. Number two is eat real foods, eat real low-carb foods. You know, follow the 6-12-12 rule. 6 carbs for breakfast, 12 for lunch, 12 for dinner, and real vegetables, fiber, and high protein, and moderate fat. Not a high-fat, low-carb diet. And number three is split your basal insulin. Now, I'm doing all these things, and here's how I see it. When you follow these things to a T, your mess-ups and your overeating, and let's say the stuff that Bernstein doesn't really talk about, if you're sitting all day, not hydrating, and you're not doing the extra stuff that people think is small but are actually a big deal, you know, getting up and moving, drinking more water, I feel like that our blood sugar is going to stay higher, but it's not going to be a range that's insane. It's not going to be crazy, you know, from 150s to 180s, crazy, and 200s. It's going to be where I'm at right now currently. So it's like all the 120s. I've just been 120 basically for the past 24 hours, just cruising there, and I won't get any lower. If this blood sugar of just staying 120 all day and taking more insulin than usual, I'll use that word, I would be confused. I would be like, why is this going on? Is the insulin like, am I injecting water? Should I just toss it out? But the fact that I have a new level of awareness this past year and just these past couple of months, but I was saying if what's going on right now was happening to the me a couple months ago, I'd be confused, mad, and just be like, oh, I'm resistant. When in fact, I'm just eating more, and it's still low carb, but it doesn't mean that I'm gonna have better blood sugars. Eating more food and eating low carb doesn't mean that you're always gonna have good blood sugars. You also have to be mindful of the level of activity, how much food we're actually eating. I'm actually eating more, and this is what I deserve. You know, like, it's not bad, it's not horrible. I am covering it with Novalin R, sometimes Novolog, waking up in 130s, 140s, and it is what it is. And I'm not in a burnt out state, but I'm just in a place mentally where I'm eating freely more. Like, you know, I'm snacking more after dinner, and like, I'm kind of like lazier. And if this is my version of a burnout, then I've come a long way. Cause when I used to burn out, you know, months ago, it'd be binge eating. It would be like blood sugars 300, injecting tons of insulin, and like rage bolusing. But now it's like, I'm cool, calm, collected. I might be snacking a little bit, might be lazier, but my level of burnout, I guess you would say, has been in a higher barometer than compared to the past time. And that's how I measure a lot of my progress. So guys, those are the top three things I would definitely want you to consider when you're following the Dr. Bernstein program. Have you fine-tuned your basal insulin? Are you eating real low-carb foods? Are you following the law of small numbers? Are you, you know, getting outside or just being active? Are you hydrating? Are you stressing less? Are you doing all these things that we tend to forget? Sometimes we need to add it all. So appreciate you guys watching. Hit the like button. Comment down below. Consider subscribing if you haven't. More diabetes videos to come.